Hello everyone, hope you guys are doing great. So I have been using DerpFest OS based on Android 12 in my Redmi Note 10 Pro for a couple of weeks as my daily driver, and the performance has been really good. So I thought to make this video and share my experience with you guys. But I won't be going into detail about all the Android 12 features, which are almost similar to other Android 12 custom ROMs. But what I will do is that I will just give you a brief overview about the extra features that you get here when you compare this ROM to, for example, Aero OS or Pixel Experience. And at the end of this video, I'll also show you how you can flash this ROM in your Redmi Note 10 Pro if you are coming straight from MIUI 12 or MIUI 13. And I also wanted to thank each and everyone for staying connected with me because my channel has crossed 1000 subscribers. Thank you so much for all the love and support. Now let's get the video started and see how DerpFest OS based on Android 12 performs with Redmi Note 10 Pro. First of all, let's take a look at the Android version and the security update. So it is running on Android 12 and the security update is of April 5, 2022. And if you talk about the performance, I have not experienced any major bugs so far, and this is one of the best Android 12 custom ROMs available for Redmi Note 10 Pro. And the performance is great, the animations are really good, and the battery backup is excellent in this ROM. And you get all these Android 12 features like material view theming, improved notification bar, privacy dashboard, notification history, and many other Android 12 features. And if you take a look at this recent application menu, you get this quick screenshot option, this clear all option, and the additional Google Lens option as well. And these are pretty handy features here. And if you take a look at the wallpaper and style, you won't be getting any extra wallpapers here, but there are like 14 DerpFest wallpapers which look great. And if you want to get those stock wallpapers, I recommend getting an application called as Pix Wallpapers. It's available for free on Google Play Store and provides a great collection of Android 12 wallpapers in addition to some other wallpaper categories. I will provide a link in the video description. Now, since we started with these theming options, you get an extra feature here known as System Icon Packs, where you would be able to change the system icon style, and this would apply everywhere like the notification bar or the device settings, and this is a very good customization feature here. When it comes to Google applications that you get with DerpFest OS, you get most of the applications like Google Calendar, Gmail, YouTube, Google Dialer and messaging applications. But you also have an option to disable most of them. But if you want to disable Google Dialer and Google messaging applications, you will need an alternative application for that. For example, if you want to disable Google messaging, you can use QK SMS, which is an open source messaging application, and then you will get an option to disable Google messaging as well. Now, the most important feature that makes DerpFest OS different from other Android 12 custom ROMs is this Derp Space, where you get some amazing customization options for status bar, quick settings panel, lock screen, and the system customization as well. I won't be going into detail about all these customization options, but you'll find some interesting options in this system customization. The first one is this Monet engine, where you can change the system theme to complete black, or you also have an option to choose a custom color here. You also get some really cool fonts and icon shapes which are definitely going to enhance your experience here. Now, the most important feature that you get here is this unlimited Google Photo storage, which is really great considering that Google Photos has limited the storage to 15 GB. And if you take a look at other customization options in Derp Space, you are really going to enjoy exploring these features here. The next feature I wanted to show you is this game space, where you get some pretty handy features like turning off notifications while you are playing the game, ringer mode, auto brightness, or keeping your screen awake while gaming. And if you want to manually add any game to this game space, you have an option at the extreme bottom here. And I have not tested any high graphics game like BGMI or Call of Duty, but I played some light games like Hill Climb Racing, Subway Surfers, and Racing Limits, and the performance was really good here. And you also get this gaming configuration where you can choose from different modes like standard, performance and battery. And you also have an option to use this angle renderer, which is an open source gaming engine instead of the native gaming drivers. Now, if you head over to the device settings, then system settings, you get a separate section for this device specific settings where you will find some really interesting features. And the first one is this refresh rate, which you can change from 60 to 120 Hz. And the second one is this refresh rate profiles, where you have an option to choose a refresh rate for individual applications. You can also choose between the default, medium, which is 60 Hz, high, which is 90 Hz, and the extreme, which is 120 Hz, and this one is an amazing feature here. You also have this DC dimming, which will help in reducing the screen flickering, thermal profiles, where you can choose the profiles for individual applications, and the last two features here are this MI sound enhancer, which will help in improving the device sound, and this clear speaker, which will check if the device speakers are blocked by any dust particles. So these were like some of the important features, and if you are wondering about the battery backup, it is really excellent here. And if you are a normal user, the battery will easily last for more than 1.5 days or 2 days, And one more excellent feature present in this ROM is this battery status provider, which you can change from the default pixel provider to the normal provider, so that you get a better idea about the battery usage. This one is a pretty excellent feature here and is not present in other custom ROMs like AirOS or Pixel Experience. And this ROM supports fast charging, and it takes around 1 hour and 30 minutes to completely charge the battery from 0 to 100% using the original charger. So it looks pretty decent here. Now, talking about this fingerprint and the face unlock, both of them work absolutely fine. Fingerprint sensor is pretty fast, so is the face unlock, and you won't find any issues with that. And if you talk about this Widevine Elven and the safety net, this ROM supports both Widevine Elven and passes the safety net test. So you'd be able to stream the SD content and use these banking applications without any issues. Now, if you talk about the cons, there are no major bugs in this ROM as I already mentioned in the beginning of this video, but sometimes you might experience these unusual things like the device screen does not turn on even when you press the power button multiple times, or the recent application menu freezes sometimes. These are not the actual cons and you won't encounter them all the time, but it might happen sometimes as I have experienced this in my device. And there is this unusual bug in the system updater where it will show you that the update is available, but once you download this update and try to install it, it won't do anything. This update is actually the same version which is already installed, and if you notice the battery usage, most of the battery is consumed by this updater. And I hope these small but annoying bugs get resolved soon. But I'm really glad that the developers have provided this Google Camera Go with this ROM instead of the basic camera that comes with AirOS or Pixel Experience. I would have loved the ANX camera, but this one will also work fine. What you wanna say to me? So this was the performance review of DerpFest OS based on Android 12 in Redmi Note 10 Pro, and I would definitely recommend flashing this ROM if you love some extra customization options. Otherwise, AirOS or Pixel Experience would also work fine. Now let's move to the step-by-step installation of DerpFest OS in Redmi Note 10 Pro, and please make sure you have an external storage like an SD card in your device or an OTG pen drive before starting this flashing process, because TWRP does not support Android 12 decryption right now, so it is better to keep these things ready. And the first important step is the unlocked bootloader. If it is not unlocked in your device, I have given a link in the video description which contains some tips and might help you in unlocking your device bootloader. The second step is that you should have a custom recovery like TWRP installed in your device. I also made a dedicated video on TWRP installation, you'll find the video in the card above. Now after the custom recovery is installed in your device and you have this ROM file present in your external storage, you can go to Wipe, then Advanced Wipe, Clear Data, Cache and the Dalvik. Then you can go to Format Data, type Yes and press OK. You can reboot your recovery or just flash the ROM and reboot the system. So this rounds up today's video on the performance and installation of DerpFest OS in Redmi Note 10 Pro, and I hope this video is helpful for you. And if you are planning to flash this ROM in your Android device, please check the video description for all the required links. And if this is your first time on this channel, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you soon in my next video.